everyone, welcome back to another video. Today is the final day of CoasterCon 44 and we're wrapping things up today at Kennywood. It is currently about 9:20 in the morning and we are starting off the day with something very, very exciting. You'll be seeing that very soon, so just hang in there, but it is going to be really cool and this is going to be an interesting experience, so just stay tuned and you'll see what it is very soon. So this is what I was talking about. We are actually getting a behind-the-scenes access tour of Phantom's Revenge. The backside of Phantom's Revenge specifically, so this is really cool. This being one of my favorite roller coasters, I've always wanted to do something like this, so I can't believe that I'm actually getting the opportunity to come back here, legally come back here, so yeah, this is awesome. I'm gonna shoot more footage of what the experience is like.
Appreciate that they focus on their poster on the sign.
So, Little Phantom ERT time, which also got a repaint, believe it or not, to purple, just like the big ride. Matt, what did you think of your most recent credit?
Oh man, it was the most intimidating ride I've ever seen. It was so scary.
And but it's purple now, just like the big Phantom.
Yeah, I don't think flying purple people it'll work like this.
There it goes. We decided to do curtain ERT time before ERT is officially over. Yeah, that's what we're doing. It broke down. We think we broke down. But we're waiting here. So they kicked us out of line.
Yeah.
We're not gonna do it this morning. Oh well. So since Kieran went down and they kicked that sideline, we're doing Irritan Racer instead. And yes, we did do the whole Phantom Irritan before this. But Phantom Tour, Phantom Infield Tour, that was great. I got a lot of good shots from that and a lot of good video footage, as you can see previously in the video. So it was. I've always dreamed about doing that, and the fact that I finally got to go back there and get some good photos and get up close to the Phantom track was an experience that I will not forget. And I'm so happy that I got to be able to finally get to have access to that area of Phantom. So it's great being back there, getting some footage and videos, and yeah, I've always wanted to do it. So. Jen and I.
Hi.
No, not Gemini. Jen and I did ERTN Jackrabbit, and now we are at the Garden Stage, sitting here and about to listen to a little history lesson about Kennywood from Kennywood history book authors. So this should be really interesting. Now I know quite a bit about Kennywood history, so let's see what I don't know.
The book's really good too.
Yes.
Yeah, I read the book this week. Lots of photos.
Yes, by the way, Jen is Matt's sister. We don't know where Matt is. He was taking pictures nearby Jackrabbit. That's the last place where we saw him, but.
For those who don't know, my name is Nick. I am the communications director for Palace Entertainment, which includes Kennywood, of course. Really great to have you guys out here. This is not my first Ace Rodeo, but it is my first Coaster Con on stage, though I think I met a number of you at Dutch Wonderland last year, and I can see someone mouthing, but I can't tell what he's saying. So we're going to do a little talk about history of the park. Who is making their first visit to Kennywood? All right, let's give it up for the
parks in Kennywood. So I've always appreciated all the help Dave has given me on my books and my research. As Nick mentioned, I have two books on the park. I grew up within walking distance and still live close enough, so when I grew up, I thought everyone had an amusement park within walking distance, and of course, I learned differently. And when I started working at the what's now the Heinz History Center, and my dad, who also grew up nearby,
or also known as the auto ride, it is our traditional antique car ride. It's got a great story for a number of different reasons. One of those is that it is, like a number of rides we have here in Kennywood, the last
very popular ride here in Kennywood for many, many, many years. But back in the mid-1960s, the big theme park boom was starting to happen. Roller coasters were starting to become
ride that, like a coaster, the steeplechase, local religious leaders had protested because riders sat on a horse in tandem, and that was just a little too close for two people to be
with local partners, machine shops in the region, to keep that ride going. And so, you know, you can never say never. It's hard to predict the future, as we all know. But we look forward to that ride being part of the lineup for many years to come as well.
For that era, the 1940s and 50s, and that's the last standing building of all the hundreds he designed. So we all have to rally around that building, and Nick, if you have any say-so in getting that restored to its original condition, we would really love to see that. It's really a landmark, and if you're just there for food, it has funnel cakes too.
Funnel cakes and deep-fried Oreos, yeah. So let's talk real quick about the carousels, and you can see, of course, the Kennywood merry-go-round. It's sometimes we call the Grand Carousel, sometimes the title is the merry-go-round. Right over here, also added in 1927, like I said, one of the last merry-go-rounds built by William H. Denzel, and you can tell that because he was a famed merry-go-round builder from that era.
Totally enclosed with three outdoor scenes as you travel past. Around curves. That was in 1926. That's also when the dragon heads were added to the front of the boats, the carved dragon heads. Well, you can see the dragon heads right now if you look at the pagoda stand.
Special favorite. It's another one of our last rides of its kind. It's what I have called for many years one of the real dark horses of this park. It, well, obviously, we talk about our roller coasters a lot, the unique collection that, you know, I think pound for pound, I'll put up against any park, even those with more coasters. But the Kangaroo is really one of those fantastic glue rides. It might not be what brings you out to the park specifically, but, you know, it is very, very frequently enjoyed by a very wide age range. There's many people that it's a dude, you know, first.
Okay, take two on the group photo. That was supposed to be yesterday, but we did not do it, so we're trying this again. Everybody's here in the same spot as yesterday. I think they'll do it this time. So yes, guys, we were finally able to take the group picture. We were supposed to last night, but ultimately didn't. Thankfully, we were able to do it today. Now I'm going to do Phantom again. And really quick, I didn't send this yet, but all throughout the park, they have these new signs that says Speedy Pass. And I am assuming that this is the new Fast Pass system that you have to pay for Kennywood. It used to be called VIP Coaster Tours. Now I'm guessing it's got a new name this year. Now it's going to be called Speedy Pass. So it looks like all the major coasters have them. So just another new thing for this year. It's no longer called VIP Coaster Tours anymore. It's now called Speedy Pass. I imagine it'll be the same thing though. Anyways, we're going to do Phantom again. Also, right before the photo, we did get to do we were able to attend the Kennywood history lesson hosted by two famous Kennywood historians, Brian Butko and Dave Hunter. They told a lot of interesting information. Of course, Kennywood be my home park. I already knew a lot of that stuff, but it was still really great to hear them speak. And you know what? Even then, there were still some things that I was not fully aware of, so it was really interesting to learn that. And it was a really nice crowd. It was at the garden stage right next to the otter race. And two very famous Kennywood legends that know a lot about the history of the park. And I think it's really cool that they were able to teach a bunch of base members the history about one of the oldest parks in America. So it was a really good event to attend. And also, I just kind of want to send a very quick update. Steel Curtain is still down. It seems like it's been down for a few hours now. Hasn't opened ever since this morning. I don't know why, but it's still closed. Hopefully, that opens later because that is on our ERT schedule tonight. So it's time to roll. You know what time it is. Nice, refreshing ride on Pittsburgh Plunge. Did Area 360 since I haven't done it in a while, and now I'm having mac and cheese at Rogue Barbecue. I haven't had Rogue Barbecue yet this year, and I haven't had their mac and cheese at all, so it wasn't that much money, so I just picked it up, and you know, it's good mac and cheese. Curtain is still down. It's like kind of like a mini lunch.
Until 2008, working here at Kennywood. Let me give you a quick background of myself. My great-grandfather was a guy by the name of A.S. McSwiggin. He bought the park. He and another gentleman, F.W. Editor, bought the park in 1906 from Mr. Andrew Mellon. For those of you not from Pittsburgh, Mr. Mellon had banks, had newspapers. Well, my cousin, who was older than me, my dad's age, said, "Oh, here's where you're going to work." And he walked through the park, out towards the turnpike. And I thought, okay, I'm going to work on the turnpike ride. And he kept coming down. He walked out into the Grove area here. Now, in my lifetime, I was 18 at the time, I'd never been in the Grove at Kennywood. We never ate out here. We ate in the restaurant. And so I'm walking through the Grove, and we walk through the Grove. We walk out to this driveway back here. They were made of metal, and they were put up as they were taken down every winter, put up every summer, right before we opened. We use it as a means of advertisement and as a means of direction. If you've ever seen a metal one, I have one in my basement. Well, I had a crew of 17 athletic guys. Anytime there was a fight in this area of the park, we would all leave the ride and go kick somebody's butt because we liked doing it. The game got us off the ride, and so we used to do it.
I called it heroin. The Superman also quite a
I haven't done it.
Make some, boy, the lights, stinks. Make some classic rides and modern thrills, including the famed trio of nostalgic wooden coasters, Jack Rabbit, Thunderbolt and Lumber, and Racer, and thrilling steel coat.
Could Lisa and Megan.
After having dinner at the pavilion, we literally did the bumper hurts backwards.
Well, I did. You tried.
No, I did. I got it backwards.
A bit.
You didn't see me. No, I did it like 80% of the time. The bumper hurts backwards. It was actually like super great doing it backwards. Right?
Right.
Right.
That's awesome.
Right. Yeah. Now we're doing fam. Forgot to mention, earlier that Thunderbolt originally scheduled for our ERT schedule will not be open tonight, unfortunately. Kind of sucks, but at least I have this credit. It's my own work, obviously I have this credit, so. But it is a fantastic roller coaster, so I feel bad for those who haven't been on it. And Venom was a great ride. We have ERT on that tonight, ERT on that, Exterminator, and some of the flat rides too. Exterminator ERT, first ride on our ERT schedule tonight. You excited? You excited? Reverend John.
I'm gonna ride it solo so I can almost.
Reverend John. Reverend John. How do you pronounce it? John or Sean?
Oh, that's what you're passionate.
Yeah. Reverend John. Reverend John Wild Mouse. We did Exterminator.
So much spinning.
A lot of spinning. We both sat on the same seat, so we were able to get a lot of spinning during the second half. Also, I had no idea this was on our ERT schedule tonight, but we're getting a behind-the-scenes tour of a Goosewood Estate. I assume that means lights on, probably. But I didn't know that they were doing this tonight. This is really cool. Gotta do that experience. We're gonna go check that out right now.
Shit. It's a horrific night.
A haunting.
We just did the walkthrough tour of Ghostwood Estate. Jen, that was awesome.
That was awesome.
And the lights were on too. We
and
were hoping for that.
Targets.
Yeah, that's. I wasn't expecting that. So like, not only did we get to walk through it, but they actually had the cars parked in each room, and they allowed us to freely shoot the targets, which is pretty awesome,
so
in my
cool.
opinion. Now it's time for the real show of the night. Well, it's right in front of us, and you probably hear it in this video right now. If you haven't guessed, yes, it's time for Phantom ERT. I actually got my first ride on ERT on this not long ago. This is actually my second ride on it during ERT tonight, and it's running super good. I missed riding this thing at night, so yes, this is a fantastic experience.
There we go.
Few rides of Phantom. Now your take time on Black Widow. At night. Sorry for the blur, it's the lights. Something that's not in my control. But just so you know, that's what it is. Finish up tonight on a couple of rides on Phantom. In fact, the most recent ride I got on Phantom was actually the last ride of the night. And not only that, but that wraps it up for CoasterCon 44. This was one of the best experiences I've ever had with Ace Guys. I mean, 4 days of Cedar Point, 2 days of Kennywood, tons of ERT sessions, great food, great people to meet, just being at two parks that really put in all their effort to make sure that we had the best time possible. Like, this was just such a memorable event, guys. Like, I'm sad that it's all over, but you know what? It's a good thing to be sad because that means I had a great time at these two parks over the past week or so. Just wanted to say, if anybody from Kennywood and Cedar Point are watching, I just wanted to say thank you guys so much. You guys did an awesome job. It's been spectacular spending the whole week with you guys. Like, I can't say that enough, guy. Just everything about this event was awesome. I liked last year's, I liked this year's. I can't decide which one I like more, but they were both equally good. Yeah, just thank you guys so much. It was amazing. Well, that's gotta do it for this weekly trip report from of CoasterCon 44 at Cedar Point and Kennywood. Thank you all very much for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode. Do me a favor, ride some rides, but most importantly, roller coasters. See y'all.